All right, what's up, y'all? Thanks, everyone, for tuning in. I'm going to keep the intro short because tonight's going to be a pretty informal stream. But basically, something that I want to get in the habit of is leveling up by watching replays. The Capcom Fighting Network, or whatever the hell it's called, CFN, is a really cool tool. It gives you access to pretty much any replays from anyone whose handle you know, and there's a bunch of like browsable menus and shit. So you basically have really easy access to like high-level player footage whenever you want. You can, if you want to study a matchup, you can just search for it and watch whatever games you want. This is something that's kind of hasn't really been that active in fighting games because we haven't really. Oh, that's my rice cooker. There hasn't really been a searchable database of footage for a while, which is it something that other games have, right? Like, it's super easy to find StarCraft replays, League not so much, but it's a super powerful tool for leveling up. And I don't know, for all of y'all who don't follow me that closely on Twitter, basically what I've been doing with Street Fighter V is I've been practicing one character every week. So I started with Fong and I practiced him for a week. And then I practiced Ryu for a week, and now I'm on Laura. And I've been having some trouble with Laura. I got in a really good set with Shady K where he beat me about 40 or 50 games in a row. And then after that, it made something click in here, but I want to watch replays to get even better. And today I'm going to focus on VRyu's replays because basically he's one of the best Lores out there. He's been grinding a lot. So he's got a lot of matchup experience. He's been putting out some cool videos too, and y'all should go check out his channel. He posts stuff on YouTube and Twitch and all and whatnot. But I'm just gonna go ahead and stalk him for a little bit, and I'm gonna be trying to commentate and take notes as best I can while I'm doing it. So I'm gonna open up my trusty little notepad, and maybe if I get something good out of it, I'll turn it into a post or something. But I figure if y'all want, you can follow along, and we can all just level up our lores together. And even if you're not playing Laura, I think this stream will be a good exercise, hopefully, in just learning how to learn about this kind of stuff, because I really think that's important if you're trying to get good at Street Fighter. So without further ado, let's hop right in. So here I am, and I have already searched for VRyu replays. This is just a chronological list, starting with his most recent games. And here I can see that he played a set of Laura Mirrors with CD Prime, which I'm pretty sure, that's CD Junior. You might know him from Mortal Kombat. And this is cool because they're Laura Mirrors. They both grinded a lot of games, right? CD Junior's at gold and VRyu's at super gold in the set. But also we get to watch Laura Mirrors, which is cool because then we can study both of the Lauras in the game and see what they do differently, which is kind of neat. So let's hop into this game. Note that I haven't really screened any of these replays in advance. This is literally me just practicing. Yeah, these could all be blow-ups. Like, maybe CD Junior really sucks. Maybe VRyu just gets owned for free. I have no idea. But one way or another, we should learn something. Also, yes, I use the Japanese voices because the English is still kind of eh. Especially Laura's English voices. It drives me crazy.
Fight.
Oh, so one thing we should probably get used to are the replay controls. So I have LB and RB to change the playback speed, and I have LT, yeah. So I can rewind, which is kind of nice. I can pause, and I can go frame by frame. I can frame skip forward, which is neat. So if we see anything that we really want to sit down and check out, then we can just replay and then pause it and go frame by frame. So VRyu is actually taking a pretty aggressive opening, which is interesting to me. Like, he starts with a jump in and just gets the pressure going, which I feel like might be a pretty, it seems like a pretty reasonable bet to start out a set, especially in Laura Mirrors, just because she really wants momentum, and it's, you know, it's entirely plausible that your opponent just isn't looking for an anti-air at the start of the round. All right, and he's basically keeping up the pressure the whole time. He's not taking a whole lot of risks. Right? Like, he's not making huge bets here and there. Oof. CD Junior gets a jump in, now it's CD Junior's time. Nice crush counter, no convert. Okay. Alright, so we still have VRyu kind of pushing in the very beginning, but he doesn't jump in this time. C CD Jr. seemed to hit a lot of things there, but didn't really convert much. And alright, now we got knocked down by VRyu. Nice reversal. Nice anti-air. Back in the corner. Another V reversal. Nice throw. So, I'm going to pause it right here and point out, so, since I'm still in the beginning of learning Laura, a lot of the stuff that I try and look for early on when I'm learning a character is not like, oh, I'm trying to study this setup, or I'm trying to, like, practice all these combos. I'll get that later, and a lot of that you can get just by researching on YouTube. The reason I'm watching these replays is because I want to know more about some of the... Some of the like smaller interactions and strings and moves that I see constantly coming out when experienced players play her. So just to go ahead and rewind this a little bit, So I'm seeing a lot of poking with stand short and stand medium punch. See, there's another stand medium punch. It's a really good pressure tool. I think it's interesting that they're both mixing up the use of normal grabs and command grabs. Laura's command grabs is, it comes out, I think, 2 frames slower than her normal grab, but since it's a command grab, you can't tech it. The other thing, if we want to rewind again, we'll see it come up here in a little bit. So, see that right there? We'll go ahead and, let's see. Here, so her V skill, you can cancel her V skill, which is the dash, right? She actually has three. She has three different permutations of her V skill, right? One is a forward or backwards dash, and the other is this like kind of cartwheel kick overhead. But the neat thing about her dash V skill is that you can cancel out of a lot of moves, a lot of her normals into it, which is something that I see a decent amount of Laura players doing so far. And we see that right here. So there's a crouch medium, and then frame. This is CD Jr. doing it, I think. He immediately cancels back into the dash, or into the back dash to get out of any kind of retaliation, and possibly bait a poke, right? And then he's at a good range to do a fireball pretty safely, right? And then that lets him cover him a little bit. Now they're in this fireball trading stance. I'm still trying to learn how to use Laura's fireball, honestly. It seems like a really important tool for covering approaches. I think it's also worth pointing out that both of them are mostly using their V meter for V reversal. They're not really using the V trigger so much. Oof, nice. That was handy too. I'm gonna see if I can pause and... it won't let me rewind after the round ends, that sucks. But, fireball, and then to get them to block, and then command grab, because her command grab is a pretty long range, is a pretty nifty thing that I've seen VRyu do a couple times. Alright, cool. Let's move on to the next one. There's a whole bunch of replays between these two, so I'll probably focus on them first. Yeah, the Laura fireball is mostly used to cover your subsequent motions. And it's, you can think, I think of it as a short-range sonic boom, basically. VRyu actually has a pretty good video on his YouTube channel, showing kind of different ways to use it after a knockdown, basically. And Dandy J is a good video on this, too. I'll link these when I put together my kind of compilation post. I see a lot of that too. I'll go ahead and back up. So like, Laura doesn't really have that much of an anti-air game. She has her quarter circle forward heavy punch, which grabs you and then slams you down to the ground. And then she has her stand medium punch is the other one that I see a lot. But after stand medium punch, you don't get a whole lot. What you can do is make them sit up into a fireball, or recover into a fireball like he does here. All right. Donk. So he jumps, boom, fireball, then grab. That's pretty cool. Again, we're seeing a lot of aggression with VRyu, but he's not actually committing to a whole lot, right? He's not going in ham. He's holding that distance. He's always ready to anti-air. Like, that's where a lot of his momentum's coming from. And he's not actually sticking that many pokes out there. We can go ahead and back it up a little bit. right? So VRyu is still pushing him into the corner, but he's not really doing a whole lot to put himself out there, right? He's using mobility, but he's always ready to anti-air, which is pretty interesting. That's something I noticed when I was playing with Shady K too. I had better luck when I was actually patient, and I was trying to look busier than I actually was, right? It seems like Laura has a hard time just running in and making stuff happen, so she... Like, even though she looks super aggressive, a lot of VRyu's play here is pretty careful. Woo! Alright, we got off a crush counter super. Okay, not much. Alright, nice V reversal. Alright, now we have a V-trigger, and then he gets grabbed. Oh well.
Round two. Fight.
Again, good early pressure. I'm not actually seeing a whole lot of the elbow, I forget what it's called, like the bolt dash or whatever, from VRyu in this matchup. He's mostly just going for fireballs and grabs. He does like that meaty elbow, I've noticed, to stop quick get-ups. Woo! That was solid. And this is another thing he shows in his video, actually, is that there's a meaty light punch elbow is actually super useful for stopping, for putting pressure on kick, quick get-ups, and if you hit it meaty, you can combo into a jab and then another elbow. Yeah, again, look at that. VRyu is doing almost nothing here. Like, for the first 10 or 15 seconds, all he does is walk forward and block. That's really smart. He doesn't even punish that sweep, which is interesting. Must have just missed it. Oof. Yeah, still, look how much blocking he did. That's scary. Like, so I think of Laura as kind of like Makoto. From Third Strike or Street Fighter 4. She feels kind of like a less good Makoto to me. And if you look at this, like, think about it that way, and then look at how much blocking VRyu does here. Block, block, fireball, block, block, fireball. He doesn't press anything. He whiffs a grab and then manages to get out. Really good. But, like, I freak out in this game if I'm blocking for more than, like, a second or two. That's really smart. That's something I'm going to have to work on. Nice setups, you got the stun. Nice. That's actually a really useful tool. We'll go ahead and back it up again. And by the way, notice that I'm not studying a whole lot of VRyu setups in the corner, because I just kind of assume that that eventually you get good enough at Laura and you learn that kind of stuff, right? Like, to me, it's the interesting thing is not learning all the different setups now. That'll come with time and practice. That's not something I want to go over now. What I'm more interested in is how he gets there, right? How he creates those opportunities. Which is why I'm not going over, like, all the different, like, fireball and towards heavy punch shenanigans, even though I know he's got a whole bunch of them. Like, to me, that's not the part that I need to work on. So that right there, the EX elbow, is an interesting wake-up tool. I don't know how good it is, but it seems pretty good. And then you get the knockdown afterwards, which is nice. Alright, now we have Nice tech. CD Jr. is not really using the command grab a whole lot. I wonder why. Oof, that was weird. What happened there? Nice.
Laura wins.
Moving right along. Wow, we got a decent amount of people watching. Thanks for tuning in, y'all. Say hi in chat. Talk to each other. Okay, let's skip
round one.
That's getting annoying to me, even in Japanese. Alright. This one, VRyu is pretty patient there. Nice counter poke. Nice dunk by CD Jr. CD Jr. isn't really getting any of the anti-airs in, though, which is tough, because I think if you're getting it jumped in for free, pretty much, you're going to have a bad time in this game in general. Nice cross under, didn't get anything off of it, though. I think Ryu's actually pretty good in this game. I lose to him all the time, and when I played with him, he felt pretty powerful, so I can understand why you would lose to 5 Ryus in a row. Alright, nice V reversal. Yeah, CD Jr. is... Okay, there we go. I feel like this is the first time that I've really seen CD Jr. get a lot. I should be calling him CD Prime. I guess he doesn't go by CD Jr. anymore. Nice, you take that first round. What made me play Laura? So in the beginning of the stream I said this, but I'm switching characters every week. So far I've played Fong and Ryu, and then this week is Laura. And on Monday it'll be a different character. I haven't decided yet. Ooh, that was interesting. I didn't know that worked. So, just to back up here a little bit. I've been seeing a lot of people use her stand medium kick, and it seems good, but I'm trying to figure out exactly why it's good and why people use it and what you can do off of it, because it doesn't really cancel on anything, I don't think. So we'll go ahead and start, from the start of the round, I guess. There's some early pressure from CD Prime. That right there. So that was a meaty or a counter hit? All right, counter hit. Gotcha. So it's a counter hit stand medium kick into a stand light kick into elbow. That's useful. And there's a counter hit mix up into the B skill, which is also handy. Wow. Boom. Ooh! I saw that in Dandy J video. You remember? Yeah. So that right there, if you missed it, basically he's got a setup to hit her overhead B skill meaty, which makes it a lot safer and I think lets you convert afterwards. Nice. So there's another. That was another good V skill cancel back into a fireball. Didn't get anything off of it, but it's interesting to me to see how he thinks it, how he uses that thing. A lot of consistent anti-airs from VRyu too. Like that's how he's creating opportunities. Is mostly by just like sitting there and making CD Prime do something. Oh, I didn't do a Fong video actually. I might circle back to him before working on some of the rest of the cast. But to be honest, I got kind of frustrated with him. I feel like he's interesting tools and he's a lot of fun, but I don't think he's that good in this game. So there's still a lot of stand medium kick and then canceling into V-skill to keep it kind of safe or move range. And I actually don't think, I mean, it's safe on block, though I think it's a little bit of a disadvantage. So canceling to V-skill makes sense, but I think it's more about just mixing up the range. Alright. Nice throw, nice overhead, and random super nice. I respect that. I feel like that thing should almost never hit. Ooh, that was bad. I wonder what CD Prime is expecting. Laura. Because I don't think that anti-air move has any hitbox until she leaves. Oh, okay, so someone's saying that CD Prime is CD Jr.'s brother. That's cool. Thanks. Thanks, Peruk. Oh, shit, that was the same one. Hold on, let me cancel this. Yeah, so, again, I really like Fong, and I think his kit is really cool. He reminds me a little bit of Crow in Rising Thunder, who I liked a lot. Yeah, I'm gonna cancel this because this was the same one we just watched. Sorry about that. I think he's gonna take too much work to be really good at. and I ain't about that life. I do have fun playing him, and I think there's some matchups where he's gonna be not bad, but he just, his tools seem powerful, but I don't think he can mix it up in close like everyone else. Yeah. So CD Prime keeps on giving up the initiative early on. He's always backing up, and that kind of lets VRyu, it gives him a lot of time and space to react to the stuff he's doing. Nice tech. Alright. Good pressure. So the stuff that he was doing there, if you see this, and by him I mean VRyu, right? So around here he's gonna hit the crouch medium kick into the elbow, boom, boom, And then he goes jab, jab, right? And then, let's see. Boom. Which is something I see a lot of Laura players doing, and I think it's useful mostly because, I'm pretty sure it blows up any throw attempts after that, it actually probably beats about everything, except for invincible stuff, after you connect with the elbow. But, so you have a frame advantage after you hit the jab elbow, but you don't, like, people still press a lot of buttons then, and the jab is a pretty easy way to hit it, like, to stuff them, and then convert it into more elbows, which is fun. Oh, and then, so that time, that's interesting, so he hits the crouch medium into elbow again, and then this time, oops, dang, press the wrong button, sorry about that. So here, boom, jab, jab. Same thing. This time he backs up, and he tries to bait like a throw or a counter poke or something, but he gets hit. Still, it's useful to know. Man, he's hitting the crouch medium a lot in this. Oh. Yeah, that's a pretty standard go-to right there. The cross-up, jab-jab to hit confirm into the jab elbow, and then if they do anything but jump, your command grab follow-up should win. Nice. Again with the blocked fireball, or the meaty fireball into command grab, and again, still not dealing with it. Ooh. I almost never see anyone use that. Nice overhead. Still no momentum from CD Prime. Like, one thing that I'm taking away from all... Ooh, again with a grab. So one thing that I'm taking away from all this is that VRyu is really good at teching throws, because whenever CD Prime goes in for a throw attempt, he almost always gets it teched, and that makes a lot of Laura's offense a lot harder to pull off. Yeah, so there he goes, going for the command grab, that's nice. Oof, that time he missed it. That was interesting.
Laura wins.
Sweet. We'll go ahead and move on to the next replay. Alright, there's a few more in this set. Actually, we can go ahead and look for something else. Actually, Nikali is another matchup that I've been having a lot of problems with, just in general. So, I'm going to watch a little bit of this Nikali stuff. I don't know what you guys do against Nikali, but I think he's a huge pain in the ass. This is something of a mismatch, just judging from the LP counts, so, I don't know, maybe we'll get to see Nikali get exposed a little bit, and that'll be useful. And if this kind of stuff is interesting or useful to you, don't be shy about following. The button's right there. I appreciate it. Wow. Okay. Get into this.
Round one. Fight.
I always feel really dumb when I get hit by that. Alright, we're still seeing a lot of just walk-up block, and that's still getting kind of blown up, but that still seems to be how VRyu's handling openings. Alright, nice punish. That was an interesting string there, why'd he do that? So, yeah, let's do that one again. Punish. So he goes from here, I think this is stand fierce punch as a meaty. That gets blocked. V-skill forward, crouch jab, and into crouch medium. That pushes it in the corner. I like that string. I'm still trying to, like, stand fear seems like a really good button for like, meaties and stopping early wake-ups, but I have no idea how to use it yet, or when to use it yet. Do I think throws are stronger in this game than in Street Fighter 4? Throws seem a little bit stronger, yeah. I think part of it is that, like, knockdowns are still really valuable. And yeah, like Mikey's saying, crouch teching is no longer as good, so throws are good.
Round two.
All right, well, fight. Our girl Laura got chewed up there. Let's see how he does in this round. Yeah, I get grabbed by that all the time. And again with a V-skill. Alright. So it seems like his go-to pressure or like response to that stomp is stand medium kick, V-skill, into pro or something. Alright, what did he do with knockdown? Ooh. I wonder why he did that. I wish I knew. Nice. Ooh, that was an interesting string. Let's see that again. Alright, so that is towards heavy punch. Hits as a counter hit. Stand light into, yeah, into jab elbow. That's good, and then throw. Gotcha. So Henry in chat is saying, after you do the punch follow-up for the elbow, an immediate stand heavy punch gives you a meaty against a quick riser. That's good to know. Thanks, man. Nice command grab. Oof. Nice. So Gotetsu, this Nikali player, still seems to be having problems with the canceling a normal into V-skill and then running out for a command grab, which is handy. But VRyu isn't really overusing it in this matchup either. There you go. Oh! Alright. Nice punish. Everyone is eating Wake Up Super for days in this game, which kind of cracks me up. When I was playing Fong, I got so many people with Wake Up Super. It was week one, so who gives a shit, but it was funny to me. Just the number of people who got hit by... Alright. Let's check another replay here. Same Nikali player. Nikali just seems super awkward. I haven't played his story mode yet or anything, but he looks like he just needs like a snack and some coffee.
Round one. Fight.
Nice pressure. Yeah, there's another V-skill dash into thing. There's that quick rise string I was talking about. So he does bone, lands the grab. That's a meaty light punch elbow into light punch into another light punch elbow. Yeah, I'm finding anti-airing to be more difficult. Also finding anti-airing to be strange because I'm like, I don't know why everyone's stand medium punch seems like it's a good anti-air. Like I get anti-aired by Ryu's stand medium punch, and I'm like, what the hell is hitting me?
Round two. Fight.
Woo! That was kinda YOLO. Nice throw. Yeah, even like when you look at Footsie's range, like VRyu isn't really pressing that many buttons. Ooh, nice jump and punch. Nice. Yeah, he seems pretty patient.
Lara wins.
Lara wins. Alright, here's another Nikali match.
Yeah,
we get the round one.
Fight.
That was a nice stand or crouch medium. Yeah, really good patience from VRyu. That's something I've been having a hard time with. Nice combo. Really nice bait, too.
Round two. Fight.
Ooh. I feel like that's one of the few times I've seen him eat just a super hard crush counter. Nice, alright, you got the counter hit forward punch. Wow. This is like one of the first times I've seen Ryu get, or VRyu get caught for pushing buttons. And that's gonna be done.
Lara wins.
Alright, well, let's see. What else we got here? We got some Karen matches. Let's see if we can find some other notable players. Ah, here's VRyu playing Chun. More Karen. Wow, that's a lot of Karen. Mika. Woo, that's a long set. I guess this is where it cuts off. Also, shoutouts to Mikey for helping out in chat. Thanks, man. I always love it when you stop by and drop some knowledge for the newbies. Alright, let's watch some of these Karen sets. Wow. So off a crush counter sweep, all he does is just push him into the corner a little bit. That's kind of neat. I know he's got more complicated setups. I'm glad to see that everyone gets hit by Karen's overhead every now and then. No one's above that.
Round two. Fight.
Ooh. Yeah, so again, a lot of blocking, a lot of good blocking. Karen seems to have a lot of good buttons. And VRyu's answer is mostly just to sit there and block a whole bunch of them. Nice in and out there. We'll go ahead and see that again with the V skill. So you got blocking right here. Boom, boom, boom. In, out. Ooh, that was sick. Keeps it simple for the finish combo off the dizzy.
Lara wins.
Lara wins. watch a few more of these.
Round one. Fight.
Again, VRyu being pretty patient. And this Karen player isn't really making a whole lot of huge mistakes either. It's funny because, like, the pace of this match is something that I actually like a lot. And I feel like the games that I've been in so far have been faster paced, which is not a thing that I like at all. I like being able to slow the game down. So that was pretty quick right there. Oof. And VRyu ate a couple of punishes to his V-skill aggression. I'm impressed that getting hit out of the V-skill dash towards once did not stop him from going for it again immediately. I don't know if that's a good thing or not, but the tenacity is useful. If you have a useful technique, you don't want to be scared from using it because they punished you once. Wait till they punish you three times, then stop using it. Nice combo from the Karen player. And again, VRyu is just kind of backing out and resetting the momentum. VRyu is missing some of his anti-airs now. I feel like Karen's gotten a bunch of free jump-ins. Wonder if it's a tilt thing, or maybe it's just not worth it. Alright, I don't know what that super was, but it doesn't seem to be a good idea.
Final round. Fight.
Oof. Nice crush counter. I'm still trying to figure out how to use her overhead V skill. I'm noticing that VRyu is counter-poking a bit more in this matchup, but it's mostly with just stand light kick. I guess you could call that a counter-poke too, the EX elbow. Ooh. Nice crush counter setup. Gonna get another one? Yep, and she's done.
Lara wins. Round one. Fight.
All right, a little bit more aggression from VRyu there, but even then, it's mostly walking forward. There's a jump, but that jump was not a risky one because Karen didn't have any anti-air options at that range. And once he's walking around in the danger zone, like the footsie's range, he's being pretty conservative. Oof, nice counter poke. Again with the V skill. Yeah, he's using stand medium kick, that knee thrust, a lot more than I've been, so that's something I'm gonna have to keep in mind.
Round two. Fight.
Yeah! That fireball was rough. So at this point, well, we'll go ahead and finish this replay first. Sweet. Get the camera on me for a second. So at this point, I've been watching VRyu's matches for about 40 minutes, give or take, and I think there's a limit to how much you can assimilate in one in one session of watching replays, especially because each time you're gonna be looking for specific things. And so a lot of the stuff that I was looking at now was, one, trying to figure out what a good lore player does in the neutral, and then two, like, what kind of tools am I underusing, right? And I mentioned this earlier, but I don't like looking for a lot of super situational or super specific tech around, like, knockdowns and mix-ups and combos and so on, because, to me, that's probably not where I'm losing the game right now, at least just from my lore play so far. A lot of it has been I'm not sure what to do in neutral. So that's more or less what I was looking for. And some of the notes that I've gotten just out of the session are, one, I need to use stand medium kick more, especially in either like kind of up close footsies or possible counter hit situations. And if I hit a counter hit or probably a meaty stand medium kick, I can get a stand light kick into jab elbow. And the nice thing is all of that stuff is safe on block, so if they block it, it's no problem. Be conservative in the neutral in general, like be persistent about walking forward. And don't be afraid to press buttons, but mostly be looking for the chance to hit an anti-air medium punch into fireball, a meaty fireball, just because that's a really good, easy way for me to just start pressure without having to give anything up. Use the V skill in and out for like basically to be aggressive with kind of X-axis movement. That's super useful, and it's something that I knew, but like to see how a good player does it is important. And then counter poking with stand light kick. So I don't know if I called this out a whole bunch, but VRyu was doing a lot of stand light kicks to try and beat other buttons, basically, or at a range where it could beat another button. And I don't really do that so much. So. And here's one of the things about like why I like to watch these replays is it's hard for me to understand why a player is using these tools just from watching the replay. I have my guesses, right? And this is part of why it's useful to watch these things, so I can try and think about it and put myself in the player's shoes, right? But some of it also is I don't know. I can see the tools that they're using, and then I can see the tools that I'm using when I go ahead and watch my replays, and they know better than I do. So at first, I like to just try and mimic whatever I can. Like, oh, they're pressing this button more, so I'm going to press this button more. And then through using it, I'll try and figure out the situations in which it's good and the situations in which that button is not so good. And it helps if I do first and then try and figure it out from there. Rather than trying to figure every reason out in advance. If that didn't make sense, basically, I like to, when it comes to fighting games, I like to learn by imitating, and then from there, put the picture together myself. So now, I'm going to go ahead with these notes on my other monitor. I'm going to go ahead and queue up for some ranked games. If anyone in chat wants to play a game too, we can go ahead and get some like battle lounges going or whatever. But first, I'm going to play a couple of ranked matches. And you get to see how fraudulent and terrible I am at this game. Let's see, we should probably put some good music on. I need to find something that is relaxed and also not copyrighted. So, ooh, I've got some stream tunes here. We're going to go ahead and jam on. Is it a pig pen? Starving Gamer, Tojo, Yeah, sure. Let's get some games in just a little bit.
Hey there. It's me again, your boy. And I'm back, so we ain't gonna waste no time on that. All right, let's get it.
Mikey, send me a link and I'll put that. I'll add that stuff to the Stream Tunes section. Let me know if the music is too much. Oh my god. You want me to listen to songs about Shin Megami Tensei? That's great. This is Pigpen, pigpen.bandcamp.com. I don't know who this person is, but it's the jams. Alright, so we got a Vega player. I have not played against many Vegas, so this will be interesting. Does Bandcamp not have a volume slider? That's annoying. No.
Round one. Fight.
The one thing that VRyu did not do is a bunch of blocked elbows, so I need to stop doing that shit. Oops. Wrong button. Oh, wow, that lasted for a while. I'm not being nearly patient enough, and I'm probably not using my V skill enough either. Oof. Actually, it would have worked out okay for me. If I hadn't lost that round. But that trade wasn't a bad idea. Oops. That was an input error. Yo, the mix-ups! Woo! Alright, we still in there. Yeah, I don't...
Final round.
I don't have strong opinions on whether Laura is good or not, but I will say that I feel like the stuff she has is stuff that everyone has. Like, I think she's just Street Fighter V, the character. Cut up. Sometimes you just have to fraud it up. Okay, so I haven't played a single character that isn't, if you get in, then it can mean the round. That's true for everybody in this game, I think. Some people more so than others, but that's what I mean by she's Laura's Street Fighter V, the character. I think pretty much everyone has a lot of potential for damage and crazy resets. It's like, if your potential for damage and crazy resets, it's like, if you considered all those tools in the aggregate to give you a score from 1 to 10 on potential for damage and crazy resets, it's like, Laura is probably at a 9 out of 10, but everyone else is at like a 7, and that's not so bad. Patience in the neutral. Ah, I fucked up my combo. I still do not yet know how to punish bisons. I'm not anti-airing enough. Ow. I got thrown out of my jab. That sucks. That's never a good feeling. Ooh. I tried to... So, there is something I've noticed that, There's something I've noticed that I have problems with it, and that's state transitions, whether it's, like, getting up or landing from a jump. I'm like, a frame late on everything. Messed that up. Man, I'm just dropping my like super easy cancels right now. That sucks. Ow. That sucks. Oof. Thought I could hop over that. Oh well. Oh man, I got knocked into the ramen shop. So, honestly, I think the mistakes in there were pretty obvious. One of it was just I was missing opportunities to anti-air, and I dropped a shit ton of combos. That's one of those losses where I don't feel like I learned that much from. I do think that I still need to get better at punishing Bison's dash at the throw, because that is... I'm just super free to that, and I don't know why. But yeah, I dropped like 10 like easy just stand medium into crouch or counter hit stand medium into crouch medium into elbow, and that's bad. Armika as a character. I like the idea of her as a character, but I don't usually go for grappler type so much. The irony. Fuck. I'm just dropping my stuff right now. But I feel like I should learn Mika because I do get wrecked by her really badly. If I block anything from Mika, press jab. Alright. Mm. That was bad. That was really bad. YOLO! Oh my god. Someday, I will get to a level where people don't lose to that. But today is not that day. I love that I'm streaming this, by the way, because all of y'all can be like, oh, that's Patrick Miller. He says some pretty smart things about fighting games sometimes, and then you just get to see me, like, fraudulently random super my way through ranked. Thanks for watching, y'all. You guys are the best. As a note, I think that playing the right music is super important for setting a good learning environment for fighting games. Because to me, like, sometimes the music is the difference between me getting salty and me just, like, taking a loss and being like, cool, thanks for the L, moving right along. Ow. That sucked. Oh. I should have V trigger canceled. So this album is Anybody Can Be Cool But Awesome Takes Practice by Pigpen. It's pigpen.bandcamp.com. Ooh. Ooh, that was bad. I thought for sure that would punish. But I am an idiot. Ooh. Oh, I fucked that up. No! Yeah, I deserve this. Oh god! Yes! Mash wake up jab. It's nice that I'm winning, but I'm not doing a great job so far of trying out the stuff that I learned from those replays. I am using stand medium kick more, and I'm getting a little better at figuring out how it's useful, which is handy. And I am trying to be more patient and neutral, but people are honestly, they're letting me jump in a lot, and I need to stop just because at higher levels, I'm not going to do that so much.
That's the thing about playing ranked mode is that it's not a great indicator of your ability. It's one indicator of your ability, but it's not the only one that matters, right? Because a lot of it is your ability to just steal like two rounds from people. You have no time to adapt, and you don't really have any time to think about it.
Round one.
And it's useful because like when you enter tournaments, you're gonna have to make your way through a lot of randoms, right? Before you get people who are who you have to adapt to. But it's also not really the most fun part. Alright, looking pretty good so far. Again, I was trying to be patient there. Ooh, that was bad. That's supposed to be a stand medium, but somehow I got a fireball. Ooh! I'm doing that way too much. But they just keep letting me. Nice. Yo, thanks for the advice on mashing jab after blocking stuff, Mikey. That's been super helpful so far. Now you're saying, when you see Mika go for a counter hit roundhouse, just neutral jump. Okay. Oh, I just emoted you. Sorry about that. Fwee fwee. Oh, gotcha. Charged roundhouse, not counter hit roundhouse. Gotta keep that stun up. All right, stun potential gone. Lucky me. Does this actually finish? I guess not. Dunk. Damn, did Kendrick just drop an album? Seriously? Just drop an album. You can be like, oh hey, I made this last week. Fuck.
Aw, yay! I guess Perfect Legend, aka Carl White, his dad went in for surgery and it was successful. That's good. You see, Beyonce recording an album when she's on tour and surprising everyone with it does not surprise me, because I just expect that Beyonce can do anything. But like, Kendrick seems like the kind of guy who spends a lot of time on his shit, you know? How did I get hit by that? I'm getting the hang of using the stand medium kick as a counter poke. Nice. Feeling good. Feeling great. How fire this album is. It's pretty dope. This track was called Dragons. Climb that ladder, baby. All right, we got a Fong player. Duck Bomb. That's a good name, Duck Bomb. I respect that name. Mix-ups. I always felt super stupid when I hit people with that. Alright, keeps on pressing buttons after that. Oh! Thanks for the comment, Ardusk. I appreciate it. Oof, that was bad. Ooh, wow, did I get hit by that? I did. No! Oh, wow. I wanted to wake up super, but I didn't. I was like, no. He's too good for that. Well, good shit, Duck Bomb. That's a good-ass name. Yep, I don't have optimized combos for stun. I'm not gonna bother with that shit yet. Cammy, another matchup that's been giving me a lot of problems lately. Worst punish. Woo! Word, you're just mashing cannon spike there. Yeah, I have a bad habit of going for throw it, even if they block the elbow, and it's not a great option, because it's just so slow. Oof. thrown out of that V skill. It seems so weird. Yeah, Mikey, I know. I feel like I should probably, like, Cammy is also on the list of characters I need to learn just because I'm gonna see a lot of them. She seems kind of less interesting, though. And this is coming from someone who played K Cammy in CBS2, like, all the time. Awesome, this match would load. That'd make me really happy. Aw, shit. We got a hot Ryu.
Round two.
Do I hate this game? Well, I don't know how much I like it. I'm gonna play it for now, because that's what you do. But it's definitely not, it's not how I like my fighting games typically. I've not found enough of the game to be about space control, and that's one of the things I like most, is I like being able to slow things down. Man, this guy's just not teching those grabs. Yeah, there's not really able to zone or whatever. And that's the stuff that I like doing more of. It's also just the pace of the game is too fast for me, and I'm not good at games that move this quickly. But it's worth playing for now. Like, I really like that in ST and in CVS2, there are ways to slow the game down so that you can kind of take your time, and if someone's, like, going ham, you can stop it, right? If you want to go ham, you have to earn it. And in this game, it just seems like it's going ham, the game. Which is nice, and I'm sure some people like that, but it's not really my shit. Oh, all that is spamming fireball is the game. That's great. Yeah, I love zoning games, so if you don't enjoy it so much, then I don't know, you probably don't agree with me on what makes a good fighting game, but if I wanted to play Street Fighter V for a long time,
I would probably just play Tekken, as it more or less feels like Tekken to me. However, I don't really like Tekken, and this kind of feels like Tekken with Street Fighter characters. Ironically, with Akuma in Tekken, that might actually be a better Street Fighter game than Street Fighter V. I did play, when I played against Shady K and got whooped, his Ryu was definitely more zoning, but I don't know if that's because he's good at it or just because I'm bad at it. Like, I don't know if that playstyle holds up at high levels. What's up, Muffin Man? Agreed. Laura's Fireball. So one of the things that I've been fucking with in training mode is actually Laura's Fireball. Like, do it after a knockdown, and then actually catch him with her super before it even hits him. And yeah, Diplosion, if you missed the beginning of this stream, I'm playing every character for a week. So my first two characters were Fong and Ryu, and from playing those two, I figured that zoning does not seem to be a great thing to be doing in Street Fighter V right now. I doubt they're gonna have a whole... I don't think there's going to be much in the way of, like, playstyles that are not get in your face and fuck you up in this game. It just doesn't seem like that's what they're shooting for. What? Word. I guess that's an overhead. That's good to know. Oof. Yeah, I played some Sim, and he seems okay. I'm surprised that got me. Alright, I can't punish anything Birdie does except for headbutt. That's good. My god, that cross up. Ow. That's a thing. Oh fuck, that's an overhead. Sweet. Later, Tojo, thanks for stopping by. That a game where there are no true block strings and you have 5-frame techable throws would be so aggressive. Huh. Let me think about that. I feel like no true block strings actually makes it so that you end up, you feel a little bit more encouraged to press buttons at the wrong time. Right? Whereas, like, games with long-ass block strings and guard meter, like CBS2, you tend to do your block string and then that pushes them out of range. And so the turns are more explicit, or in this game they aren't, right? As for whether it'll be more defensive, possibly. I think there's a conscious effort to make this game about getting in your face and fucking shit up. And so because of that, I don't think that they'll ever really have great zoning tools. I think if we do see great zoning tools, they probably won't stay great for that long.
Round one. Fight.
All right, another Vega.
That was a bad button. Oh, wow. Well, there goes my stun chance. Oh, well. What? Mikey, did you cosplay at EVO 2003 and pass out in the hallway of the hotel? I don't remember you cosplay. Didn't I meet you at EVO 2003? Oh, you were wearing a bikini top. Wow, nice. I guess I met you at 2004, right? One of those two. Card 16. Fight. I'm feeling myself go on autopilot a little bit. Yo, shout out to the Shiloh Inn. I think it's called something else now. Shout out to the Shiloh Inn, aka the hotel that looked like a pyramid and smelled like weed smoke the moment the FGC got up in there. Oh, that was bad. Alright, there we go.
Yeah.
Muffin Man's asking me what I was playing at EVO 2003. I believe I was playing CBS2 and Guilty Gear. Oof. Alright, well. Alright, well, these jams are pretty dope, but I'm actually going to call it for tonight. I may play some games a little bit later if you see me online, but I'm on autopilot. I'm not really doing a good job commentating for the stream right now, so I think that's probably the my endurance. Also, my neck kind of hurts for some reason. But I'll switch over to the webcam view. I hope y'all got something out of watching the stream. I'm going to try and do this on the regular. If you're new to the stream, I try and do like analytical educational stuff around fighting games all the time. Sometimes it's just me streaming myself play, but even when I do that, I'm going to be reviewing replays and stuff like that. So if that's the kind of thing you're into, by all means, check it out. You can also find some of the, you can find the videos, like the archives at youtube.com/pattheflip, so you can check that out too. And yeah, if this kind of thing you're into, go ahead and give me a follow. And for those of y'all who just keep tuning in whenever you see the little notification to go up and say pattheflip is streaming, thank you so much. It means the world to me. Also, shout outs to Mikey for helping out in chat. Honestly, like, I really appreciate it when you stop by and help the newbies out in chat with stuff that I can't get to on the stream itself. So thank you so much. Peace out, y'all. I'll be back when I'm back. Later.